history of the second old man and the two black dogs, great prince of the genies. You must know most generously, and I am therefore powers of the fairy and thanked her as well as I was able for the great obligation she had conferred on me. "But, madame," said I to her, "I must entreat you to pardon my brothers." I related to her what I had done for each of them, but my account only increased her anger. "I must instantly fly after these ungrateful wretches," cried she, "and bring them to just punishment. I will sink their vessel and precipitate them to the bottom of the sea." "No, beautiful lady," replied I, "for heaven's sake, moderate your imagination, and do not execute so dreadful an intention. Remember, they are still my brothers, and that we are bound to return good for evil." No sooner had I pronounced these words than I was transported in an instant from the island where we were to the top of my house. I descended, opened the doors, and dug up 3,000 sequins which I had hidden. I afterward repaired to my shop, opened it, and received the congratulations of the merchant in the neighborhood on my arrival. When I returned home, I perceived these two black dogs, which came toward me with a submissive air. I could not imagine what this meant, but the fairy, who soon appeared, satisfied my curiosity. "My dear husband," said she, "be not surprised at these two dogs in your house. They are your brothers." My blood ran cold on hearing this, and I inquired by what power they had been transformed into that state. "It is I," replied the fairy, "who have done it, and I have sunk their ships for the loss of the merchandise it contained. I shall recompense you. As to your brothers, I have condemned them to remain under this form for 10 years as a punishment for their perfidy." Then, informing me where I might hear of her, she disappeared. The 10 years are now completed, and I am traveling in search of her. This, O Lord Genie, is my history. Does it not appear to you of the most extraordinary nature?" "Yes," replied the genie, "I confess it is most wonderful, and therefore I grant you the other half of this merchant's blood." And having said this, the genie disappeared, to the great joy of the merchant and of the two old men. The merchant did not omit to bestow